The DTA of Namibia has expressed concern over the Bank of Namibia's inconsistent treatment of the board members of SME Bank, who were dismissed on allegations of fraud and misappropriation of funds.
Last week, we read in the newspapers and on the TV and radio, we heard that the Bank of Namibia backtracked on its decision and the old board and the CEO and other senior officials of the bank that has been dismissed, has been removed, has taken up their positions again, and because of some other problem, legal problem, mistakes that the Bank of Namibia made. It was shocking. It was shocking. It is actually unbelievable that it can happen at the institution of the magnitude of the Bank of Namibia, who's in charge of all the money of this country, that the governor of that bank can make such a blunder.
Smit could not understand why the line ministry, that is of finance, and the head of state always remain tight-lipped when dubious investments are made involving public funds.
Has somebody now realized that a mistake has been made to dismiss those people, a political mistake? So now we are putting this thing on the back burner, just as we have put the GIPF case on the back burner, the Cora issue on the back burner, the Social Security issue of the other day, where two urban were bought for 15 million Namibian dollars above its price. All those things have just been swept under the carpet. Is this also now happening here?
Smith says government is already facing an economic crisis and a flood up north where millions are likely to be spent. If parasitals are allowed to lose any more millions, the tide could turn for the worse for the country, especially with a predicted 0% growth in the economy for the year ahead.